1600s, Ireland was named Wolf Land because it had so many wolves. And the North American gray wolf population was 2 million. Wolves are fascinating animals, yet often misunderstood by humans, which they share the planet with. Let's explore their world together. Walk through their ranged habitat, take a glimpse of their physical traits and feeding and hunting habits, and add into their unique feeding and hunting habits. And finally, check their current numbers and threat of extinction that still exists. Wolves are mainly found in the northern hemisphere. They can survive in forests, tundra, mountains, swamps, and deserts. The gray wolf ranges across the U.S. Northern Rockies, the Pacific Northwest, and Western Great Lakes region, and from the U.S.-Canadian border north to the Arctic, including Alaska and Greenland, as well as some on the Arizona-New Mexico border, with little numbers struggling to survive in Mexico. A wolf's average lifespan is 6 to 8 years, although the record lifespan is around 20 years. The smallest wolves live in the Middle East, where they can weigh only 30 pounds. The largest wolves inhabit in Canada and Alaska, and can reach up to 175 pounds. Wolves normally walk 8 hours per day, which means that they can walk 4,000 miles a year. A wolf can run up to 40 miles per hour when necessary, but only for a minute or two. Wolves run on their toes, which helps them stop to turn quickly to prevent their paw pads from wearing down. A wolf's pup's eyes are blue at birth. Their eyes turn yellow by the time they're about 8 months old. When it comes to tracking movement, wolves' eyes can be extremely sensitive. And a wolf's winter fur is especially well adapted to the cold and can help it comfortably withstand temperatures up to 40 degrees below zero when curled up. Wolf fur does not collect ice when warm breath is condensed against it. Wolves howl for many reasons. As a way of communicating with other wolves, when they are rallying for a hunt, when they are communicating with other packs of wolves, or to call and guide one home. Pack members recognize each other's voices and will do anything to protect their pack, including dying for their pups. Biologists have found that wolves respond to humans imitating their howls. In fact, the International Wolf Center in Ely, Minnesota, even sponsors howl nights where people can howl in the wilderness and hope for an answering wolf call. People can learn how to howl in the Wolf Center Howling Safari. And guides will take groups out into the wild to try out what they learned. Although guaranteed responses happen at the center itself, where visitors can howl with the residents' pack. One visitor described the response as immediate and electrifying. Wolf mating season is from January to February. And once a wolf has found a mate, they will stay together for life. The alpha female have litters up to 6 pups each year. During their first months, pups are completely dependent on their mother's milk. They are gradually weaned, so when they are 7 months old, they already start hunting with the adults. Wolves rely on their hearing and sense of smell to detect their prey. Wolves have about 200 million scent cells, while humans only have about 5 million. Wolves can smell other animals from more than a mile away. Sometimes wolves hunt alone, but they have an advantage when hunting in packs because they're intelligent animals working together and able to take down much larger and stronger animals. Wolves are strict carnivores. They do not kill for sport, but for survival. They are also scavengers and hunters, and will eat anything that catches from large mammals to small rodents. Some of the animals wolves hunt and eat include deer, moose, caribou, elk, and bison, as well as smaller animals that such as beavers, hares, and other rodents. Wolves have large stomachs and can devour 20 to 25 pounds at a single feeding time. However, a wolf is able to survive for 2.5 weeks with an average of only eating 2.5 pounds per day. Their digestion is very efficient, with large feeds able to be digested. And any splinter of the bone that is not broken down somehow becomes wrapped in undigested hair, which protects the animal from an injury. Wolves have 42 highly specialized teeth, or their canines or fangs, measured to be around 2.5 inches long. And they also have large molars for crushing and grinding bones. And a wolf has a biting capacity between 1,000 and 1,500 pounds per square inch. The U.S. Endangered Species Act first listed wolves in 1973, but there's always been talk about taking them off the list. Red wolves are currently most endangered, with fewer than 50 in the wild and 200 in captive programs across the United States. In 2019, the estimate of wild wolves around the world was 300,000 in the wild. Minnesota has the highest percentage of wolves in America, with roughly 2,655 wolves. Gray wolves once had the largest range of any species, spanning throughout Eurasia, North America, and Africa, covering the entire continental northern hemisphere. Currently, the gray wolf inhabits a reduced portion of its range, largely due to human activity and habitat destruction. They were nearly hunted to extinction in the continental U.S. due to threats posed to human safety and livestock. Although they were put on the endangered species list, they have been reintroduced in some areas, such as Yellowstone National Park. And today, the wolf population in North America is approximately 65,000. With a world population of 150,000 wolves. But 24 species of wolves are already extinct. Now that we explore the world of wolves together, their range and habitat, physical traits and feeding and hunting habits, perhaps now we all will understand that extinction still threatens these amazing animals. And we can learn even more about what can be done to protect them and their environment, so that future generations can also enjoy these fascinating animals.